Whether you are working at home for the short term, the long term, or as an adjunct to working at the office, you want to make your workspace as professional as possible. One reason is your health. It's too easy to injure yourself through bad ergonomic setup. Another reason is efficiency. Having the right equipment and setup will let you be more productive with less stress. Let's start with the setup of your work environment. If you are routinely working from your kitchen table or couch, stop. You'll easily injure yourself. You want a separate workspace, such as a separate home office, a guest room or shed that doubles as a home office, or some nook in your home or porch that you can set up your desk in. If you don't have a desk, you can use a table. Just make sure you have a dedicated place for your computer. Get yourself the equipment you need, a chair, your computer, one or two monitors, a mouse or trackpad, and a keyboard. You might also want a docking station, a backup drive, a DVD drive, speakers, webcam, or other equipment based on the work you do and what comes with your computer and monitor. It's easy to forget about lighting, but lighting can make or break a workspace. You don't want to work in the dark, as that can cause eye strain. So you want good light levels, but you want your lighting to be indirect, so you avoid glare. That means you don't want lamps shining on your screen, and you don't want strong light from adjacent lamps or windows competing for your vision. Make sure any side lamps have their light angled away from your screen. If you have a window behind your screen, have a shade in use during the day. If you have a window behind you, try to move your desk so that doesn't happen, and if it can't be avoided, pull down a shade or draw a curtain to cut off its light. The top surface of your desk or table should usually be 29 inches above the floor, so you can sit up straight with your forearms parallel to the ground. That way, you don't create awkward posture that can damage your muscles, tendons, or joints. Desk height of 29 inches may be too high or too low depending on your height and build, so you may need to adjust the height for your body. If you can use a keyboard tray, do so. It should also hold your mouse or trackpad. A keyboard tray lowers the top of your keyboard and input device to proper desk height, while letting you use the desk surface for paper-based activities at the proper height. The best keyboard trays also let you tilt the keyboard inward, so you don't need to raise your wrists when using the keys at the back. Your chair should be at a height that lets your forearms be parallel to the floor and the wrists slightly down when typing or mousing when you are sitting up straight. It's preferable to have an adjustable chair so you can get the best height and angle for your body. It's also preferable to have armrests, but be careful. Your arms should just lightly touch the armrests while typing or mousing. Never push your arms into the armrests while working, as that can cause arm and shoulder strain. Your monitor should be positioned so that when you look straight ahead, your eyes are at about 25 to 30% from the top of the screen. This position helps prevent shoulder and neck strain. You may need to use a riser to get that correct height. If you use a laptop as your primary computer, and many of us do these days, don't use it routinely on your work surface. Doing so contorts your shoulders, neck, upper back, and arms in damaging positions. Instead, use an external monitor, keyboard, and mouse to get the proper posture. You can also raise the laptop to use its screen as a monitor if you don't have a separate monitor. Here's a tip. Get a foldable stand you can pack in your luggage when you travel for several days, along with a mouse and keyboard, to raise the laptop screen in a hotel room, conference table, or other temporary workspace. Okay, now you are ready to create the right workspace at home. Make sure you have the equipment you need and an ergonomic setup. That way, you can work productively and safely for as long as you want or need.